Hello, and welcome back to Jemi Plays Amnesia the Dark Descent. So, we just entered the laboratory. Alright. Time to... Oh! Come on! Explore. I'm a little calmer than I was before. The lack of chimney to properly vent the fumes from my most recent experiments has taken its toll on many of the less stable ingredients in storage. Some seem unaffected, but many are stained by the fumes and will be difficult to salvage. I shall do what I can and move them to the wine cellar. That was the place that was locked. Okay, so... I guess to do anything here, we're gonna have to get into the wine cellar.
There should be more coop rats. Let me see. And one guard, Aquafortis.
This is my third attempt to produce artificial vitae. The former compounds lack the potency I needed, but I sense I'm close. Calamine and orpiment are a given, and the culprite binds them well. This time I shall attempt aqua regia instead of aqua fortis, and in hope that it will produce a more even solution. The experiment was unsuccessful. The solution is highly acid and provides impractical to put to use anything except as a detergent. Organic tissue reacts especially violently to the solution and should be handled with the greatest of care. I might be able to use the recipe, but I'm losing hope that I will find an alchemaic solution to my predicament. Blah, blah, blah. I read that terribly. Evidence, Labrador... some sort of a... Aha, I see. We're supposed to make that acid so we can go move on. One day I will return. If it wasn't for the thought of you, my love, I wouldn't be able to go on. When I find myself doing terrible things, I take comfort in you. As long as I'm able to think of you and long for life together, I know I'll be better than the others. I know I'm better than the others. I weep for them. They lust for power without restraint, where I only crave fair judgment and a safe return. I don't get that. Just a jar that... Cool, whatevs. I don't know why today, man. I'm, like, super brave. Something's gonna happen. My column is gonna get messed up. I know it. But we're gonna enjoy this ballsiness while it lasts. Ooh, flex! Shift was to run. Nope, no, no. Alright. Woo! A little jogging. The door slammed shut behind him, and he knew he would never again see the tailor at Berkeley Square. Another lone soul in London seemed appropriate somehow. These are weird little quips in between, like... the loading. They don't seem to... Are they Daniel's memories that just... Lady, you get away from me! I won't be where you are. like how it's lit up in here. Archives. It won't budge. Say hello, hello. Oh, this is the last place to go. Let's get it done. He fell to the kitchen floor. Tears were beginning to well in his eyes as he received the first kick to his stomach. Hazel remained hidden in fear she too would be punished. I feel like I read that one before. I don't know. Maybe not. It's just what else. If it'll load. Oh, here we are. Rare books. Of course I want to go in the room with the door ripped off first. That makes sense. Screw you, roaches. You ain't got nothing on me.
16th of May, 1839. The unflinching African sun has continued to plague our expedition, making it impossible to dig until dusk. How Professor Herbert managed to find the location in these vast plains of nothingness remains a mystery to me. When I asked him about the tomb again, he told me about the legend of Tin Hanan, the mother of us all. An interesting story in its own right, but I can't help feeling there's more. Later that evening, we uncovered a passage beneath the dunes leading to a sand-covered stone structure. The professor was confident it was the tomb we sought and ordered the others to clear the way late into the dark, cold night. Tomorrow, I shall lead the men into the ancient structure, hoping to reach the burial chamber. No matter what the professor is keeping from me, the dig should yield something interesting to take back to London and the British Museum.
Oh man, it's always cursed African artifacts. Like, is there nothing in Africa that's not cursed? Mummies? Everything. Okay, bookshelves, nothing. I guess just, okay. Catalogs. Yeah! I hereby offer my full attention and services to Alexander Baron of Brandenburg. This contract will reign for a total of 3 years when my freedom shall return to me. In addition, Alexander Baron of Brandenburg is to recommend my services at the Prussian Royal Court and within the sanctum of the Order of the Black Eagle. May no man break this seal. Wilhelm, House of Greenwich. Gerich? I want to say Greenwich, but that's not right. Oop. Daniel's freaking out. Ugh, my allergies are bothering me, and I... Excuse me for that. I should start from the bottom and work my way up, so... I won't ever get confused. Alright, nothing here. Booyah! Steady. I opened it like a badass and I just like opened it like a tard. Alright.
17th of May, 1839. My hands tremble as I write. I feel a need to document my tribulation, for I fear that my memory will fail me if I linger. Today, I took some men and ventured into the dark, ancient passage we uncovered. Our torches burned faintly in the murky air as we slowly made our way underground. The men were superstitious and fearful, They argued loudly, and I felt their strange language getting to me. I mustered my strength and yelled at them to continue down the slopes and broken steps. The crudely carved passage confused me. It looked much older than the 4th century structure we had expected. The twisting path emerged into a great antechamber. The walls were lined with statues unlike any I'd ever seen. Despite their unearthly quality, I felt a strange familiarity toward them, which haunts me still. At the far end of the chamber, a great slab of stone sealed off whatever lay ahead. I gave the order to raise it, and as I pushed through the narrow space, the heavy stone suddenly dropped, sealing me inside. I was trapped.
Oh, wow. That's intense. Alright, but this is the end of this video. I've run out of time. And so we'll pick up with the next one. Thanks for tuning in!